It's your girl, Denise Joy. Welcome to another episode of Transformation for Your Home. Whether it's DIY or professional help, you can make your home a destination you'll love. Hey, good people, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl, Denise Joy, designer at the Faraha Method of Joyful Design. By the way, Faraha means joyful in Swahili. I'm thrilled that you're joining me today. When you get a chance, please hit the like and the subscribe button. It really helps with the algorithm, and it helps me to reach women all over the globe. In this video, I invite you to come along with me and watch me decorate. I put together a room refresh on a budget. This video is full of ideas, tips, and inspiration to help you transform your room the custom on a budget way. I know exactly how it feels to look at a room and imagine, how did it get this way? The thing to remember is it doesn't have to stay that way. Let's go through the 5 easy steps to help you refresh a room on a budget. Step number 1, all important, you have to make a plan. In design, we call the plan a mood board. You can go ultra fancy, design a mood board using Pinterest, create a mood board using PowerPoint, or you could just sketch something on a piece of paper. The idea is you've got to have a plan. I encourage you to use technology to your advantage. Check out spaces on Pinterest and even house.com. You can get great ideas. Let your imagination run wild. We'll get to budget in a minute. Step number 2, prepare your space for the transformation. A typical small room transformation will take you around a week to maybe even 2 weeks, depending upon how much time you have available. So don't get frustrated if everything's not finished in one day. Step number 3, to refresh and transform a room, I always recommend you use some paint. Whether you're painting an accent wall or the entire room, painting is the cheapest, quickest way to transform a space. You want to purchase your supplies. You can get great supplies from Amazon. I'll drop a link to that below. Or just shop in your local big box store. Pro tip. Take good care of your supplies. If you're going to continue to do DIY projects, you'll want to clean your supplies so you can reuse them for other projects. I am all about helping you to save money, do things the smart way, and get that wow factor. Go ahead and give this video a thumbs up. I know you're loving it. Remember to follow the directions on your paint can. Yes, read the paint can. Or do your research, watch videos, read articles, but typically you need to let wall paint dry at least 4 hours between coats. That way you get a really good cure on the paint. While you're painting, be sure to protect things you don't want paint to get on, like the floor, or if you have some furniture that you can't move out of the room, make sure you cover everything well. Floor covering hack. Go to the thrift store, get some old curtains, don't get the most expensive ones, and use those as your drop cloth. Step number 4, you are going to repurpose as much furnishing as you possibly can. That's right, I want you to go and shop your own home first. Most homeowners have pieces in their home that could be repurposed and used better in a new location. I'm sure that's the case for you too. If that's you, drop me in the comment section below. Now for your budget. I believe that most room transformations can be accomplished for under 500 bucks. How do you do that? Well, that leads us to step number 5. For pieces that you don't have that you need to purchase, you're going to shop the online discount stores like Wayfair and TJ Maxx and even Overstock. They don't advertise themselves as discount stores, but that's pretty much what they are. A great strategy is to shop when those online stores have sales, typically around holidays. The other way you're going to save big is to shop at thrift stores and use online shopping platforms like Facebook Marketplace. What room are you thinking of transforming in your home? Drop it in the comment section below. In this room transformation, some of the wall art, the small decor, and the lovely sheer curtains all came from the thrift store. For the grand finale, remember to set aside at least 5 to 6 hours to completely set up your staging and your styling of your transformed room. This homeowner wanted to turn this gloomy, outdated laundry room into a fun space to do her laundry and to hold extra storage. Now this room can do triple duty: laundry, seasonal storage, and store all the tools. When you're planning and thinking about transforming a room, I want you to keep these 3 design principles in mind: color, pattern, and texture. Design is really all about individuality. Redesigning a space gives you an opportunity to showcase who you are and let the world know you are unapologetic about it. Your home is actually your ultimate retreat. Vacations are cool, don't get me wrong, but there's nothing better than having a space you love so much that when you leave, you can't wait to get back to it. And please don't neglect storage, no matter what room it is. This home, the homeowners were at their wits' end with their tool storage area. But when you have time, patience, and a plan, you can work miracles. Design and decorating your home is not about copying something you saw on a TV show. It's about tapping into who you are and creating a home that motivates you, inspires you, and is your sanctuary to regenerate. Whether it's my own home or I'm working with a client, I'm always using the principles of joyful design to give the homeowner a space they will truly love. Go ahead and give this video a thumbs up. I know you're loving it. What room are you thinking of transforming in your home? Drop it in the comment section below. And let me know, what furniture do you think you can repurpose? And hey, the new purchase cost to transform this room. By the way, the total purchase to transform this dingy, dated laundry room and turn it into a room with a sunny disposition was just $1,400. If you enjoy HGTV style shows, be sure to check out my show, Fix My Room, here on my channel. Every home has that problem room, and in every episode, I share inspiration, tips, and ideas to help you fix it. It's full of DIY design solutions. The link to the show is below. Thanks so much for stopping by my channel. I really appreciate it. Please don't forget, hit the like and the subscribe button. It helps me reach women all over the globe. I'll see you in the next video.